Hello, everybody. Yes, you've read the title correctly. We're going to attempt to be salt-free. Of course, much of that depends on you guys. Let's start off the right way, though. Denver sucks in the chat. That'll make me happy. That'll be a good way to start. So I'm going to try something here at the beginning, just in case it doesn't work. They have added a little feature down here that says I can share my screen. So I'm going to try that real fast. We're going to see if this works. Google Chrome would like to... What do I have to do? Do I have to do something? Okay, share. Now, I want to know, can you guys actually see this here? If you can, you're looking at the sunspot number absolutely exploding, and the biggest sunspots are not even turned over the limb onto the Earth facing half. Now, I'm going to go ahead and stop sharing this for a second. I should see that. Could you guys see that? Black? Nope, can't see. No pictures. YouTube sucks. All right. Denver sucks in the chat or YouTube sucks in the chat. We're going to take either one. Didn't work. Clowns. Clowns. All right. Well, hey, what I was trying to show you is that the sunspot number has absolutely exploded over the last 5 or 6 days. I'm going to admit, when about 6 days ago I said, hey, guys, expect the sunspot number to be going up, it's a little more than I would have expected. Counterpoint, to have this many sunspots and have only a couple M-class solar flares, it really is just a modest bit of activity. And so I suppose we can be thankful for that. But again, the biggest sunspots, the ones that gave us those X-class flares a couple weeks ago, those ones are turning back in. I can start to see the peripheral magnetic plagues around it. It looks like at least the leading edge of it may have decayed, but again, that big sunspot group is coming back. So, Rich says, how could there be so many people down on Denver? Rich, have you been there? Crazy Scott, you are appreciated. And thank you to Logan, who I saw added to the SALT Fund earlier. Let me adjust that slightly. There we go. So, I'm wearing one of my favorite shirts. Do you guys at least like the shirt? Okay, I get it. You couldn't see the screen share of the sunspots, but this is a hell of a shirt right here. So, I figured this was appropriate. And I guess we'll start off the whole disaster and next age of Earth story. Neural Channels, thank you very much for the support. I wanted to ask you guys, how's it going with you guys trying to wake people up? Is that going well? Or are you finding that my advice to not talk about Fight Club is the right way to go? I'm actually looking at the checks. I really want to know. It's hard to talk about this stuff with normies. It's impossible with NPCs. Absolutely impossible. Please explain the volcanic tale of Hawaii. I would love to. I would love to. So, first of all, the axes of the turn, when the Earth turns over, the points on the side here, they're not changing latitude. They're just turning 90 degrees, like we see with the volcanic arc. The isotope dating of the Hawaiian Islands is absolute nonsense. It is way, way younger than they say it is. Furthermore, when it comes to something that keeps popping off volcanoes, whether it's like Hawaii or it's like Yellowstone, we are not talking about a hot spot in the mantle. I know that's what science says. It's complete nonsense. In a liquid ocean of rock, there's just a hot spot. Does that even make sense to you? No. It's a hole in the bottom of the crust so that wherever it is, magma's going to come up through it. That's what all the long-term volcanoes are. It's not that they magically migrated to a different latitude and happened to be over a hotspot again. The hotspot idea is nonsense. It doesn't even make sense. It's a hole in the bottom of the crust. Anyway. I suppose we should just get to it. I should be answering more questions, huh? Oh, wait, I saw one up there. I'm about Hapgood and Earth Crust. What do you think? You haven't done your homework, obviously, because Charles Hapgood was a CIA agent masquerading as a professor whose goal it was to tank this science. He was in the Pentagon meetings back when he was an officer with the OSS, the Office of Strategic Services, which morphed into the CIA. He was at those Pentagon meetings when Major White gave them the evidence from Project Nanook, and the Pentagon scientists and the RAND Corporation determined that the Earth tilts over 90 degrees. It's the only way to explain all of the evidence. They know that. They knew that back then. They didn't want people to find out. They had already classified most of that stuff from Project Nanook. So what do they do knowing that they can't keep this a secret forever? They intentionally tank the science. They say, Hapgood, you're going to go just be this lowly professor here, and you're going to come out with this theory. It's going to get a lot of people riled up. We're going to have Einstein write the foreword for it, or at least make up that he wrote the foreword for it. He was already dead by the time the book came out and the theory came out. And essentially, his whole like, oh, it's a 7-degree tilt and it takes thousands of years. That's so easily debunkable that they did debunk it, and it tanked the entire idea that Earth can tilt over. And it was done absolutely on purpose. That's what I think of Charles Hapgood. But anyway, all right, what did I miss here? Tacos or burritos? Neither. Not on this diet, buddy. Back when I would eat them, back when I used to eat them, it would depend. If we're talking, we're just going cheap and picking up fast food, burritos. If we're talking like restaurant quality stuff, a good fish taco, absolutely. Mahi, fish tacos, with diced tomatoes, diced onions. Are we really doing this here on the show? Swarm data. I have heard nothing. I've heard nothing out of the Swarm conference. Apparently, a couple folks went. I don't know. I haven't gotten any emails about it. If I have, I haven't gotten to them yet. So far, I haven't heard of any kind of updates out of the Swarm conference. Maybe I'll check a little more into that. Bruce asks, was the biblical flood 6,000 or 12,000 years ago? I believe it was 6,000 years ago. Had you over to my place. Fish tacos. Who knows what movie that's from? Please clip that Hapgood answer out for an ex post. I mean, in theory, I could. You know what? It's a fantastic idea, Melinda Liu. I'm just going to be totally honest with you. I'm not going to end up doing that. If any of you want to clip that out, post it on X or TikTok or wherever you want to post it, feel free. Go right ahead. I can just tell you right now, I'm probably not going to do that. But anyway, what did you mean on... What did you mean on X when you said not aliens, something worse? Okay, that is a cool comment. So, one of the best astrophysicists in the world right now is a guy from Harvard. I know. It's Harvard. He happens to be probably the only guy at Harvard with his head screwed on straight. His name is Avi Loeb. And he came out and said They are opening interdimensional portals at CERN. For those of you who watch all my stuff, you already know I've been talking about this before. But now, Harvard professor, the only professor at Harvard I respect, and I do respect him, Avi Loeb is no joke. He's one of the guys who put forth the milli-charged dark matter idea and, you know, talks a lot about the issues in astrophysics and cosmology. The guy's no dummy. He's not bought and paid for, and he's got my respect. He says they are opening interdimensional portals at CERN for aliens. And my comment on X was, not aliens, something much worse. Don't forget who runs the show. They're Satanists. Did you guys hear about that new disease where people see demon faces? If you didn't hear about it, you can literally Google. This is even on mainstream Google. Type in new disease, people see demon faces. Yeah, it's not a neurological disorder. We are being shown. All is revealed in the end. But yeah, I meant demons. I meant demons. I absolutely did. With an ocean of water trapped in the crust, it's actually three times Earth's oceans trapped in the crust, and another two in the mantle. Any ideas on temporary sea level rise in the years following the big flip? Oof, that's such a good question. Of course, a lot of that depends on how much comes up versus how much extra goes down. When the Earth turns over and we get the great earthquake, that's a lot of fracturing, a lot of water down. A lot of the waters below will come forth. Where that measures out, is it more this way? Is it more? I'd be lying to you if I said I knew. That's one of these things. Alan Shepard, what a great question. You guys might not believe this, but I love when we get a question that's so good that I can give facts about what might be involved, but I can't give you the actual definitive answer. Things that I don't know the answer to are the only things that actually fascinate me anymore. I mean, I enjoy the stuff that we do. I enjoy space weather, earthquake science, catastrophism. I enjoy learning about it and figuring stuff out and sharing the information. But in terms of genuine fascination, it's questions like Alan's that actually get me going. So thank you, Alan. But again, I don't know where that's going to all shake out in terms of water, you know, trickling down into the crust through cracks and things like that versus, you know, what's going to come forth. Also, here's another thing that goes into that. Don't forget, some land is going to rise, some land is going to fall. If more land rises than falls, sea level rise will happen. If more land falls, you know, there's so many of these things that we just can't know the answer to. But again, two claps for Alan there. Great, great one. Mountain Wolf 01 says, always great content. I really appreciate that. I work on the internet, so I get a lot of shit talking done at me every day. So thank you. Appreciate that. I love your shirt. Yeah, me too. That's why I bought it. Okay. Terry, yes, you were wearing your version of this shirt when you met us in Charlotte. It made me smile. Man, wasn't Charlotte a cool, cool event? That was a cool event. I enjoyed that. Have I heard of Dr. Egon Cholakian? No. And the Earth Save Science Collaborative, his opinion on magma pushing towards the crust in Siberia causing pole shift. No, that's not what's causing the pole shift. Whatever's happening right now, it is a cycle. It is on a shockingly good cycle. And also, magma pushing towards the crust in Siberia wouldn't be moving the South Magnetic Pole. And it probably wouldn't be moving the North Magnetic Pole either. This is the galactic current sheet. Kudos to Egon Cholakian. That's a hell of a name. And like his name is Egon, like Ghostbusters. Glad he's on to the fact that we're in the middle of a pole shift, but there's just too much evidence that this is due to something else. Wish him the best, though. Hi from Florida. Hi from Colorado, Ben Adams. You have a cool first name. Observer Ranch weekend event, question mark. I don't know what you're asking, Drew's Daycare. There will be many weekend events at Observer Ranch. Ben, would you ever go on Joe Rogan? Yeah, I would, but I haven't been invited. Going off the water from below coming up, if the sun and moon don't move in relation to Earth, could explain glaciers. Maybe. Drew's Car Care, you ask again, Observer Ranch weekend event. I don't know what you're asking here, Drew. Please be more specific. Thoughts on the Long Valley Caldera? I hope it doesn't go off. That's not a good one. That's not one of the fun, nice volcanoes. That one's mean. Gas Giants Bro, question mark. October, question mark. Christopher Cook, that ain't a question. That's not a question. But since I know what you're asking me, let me go ahead and give this answer for like the 100th time. Planetary alignments matter. Squares, trines, all planets on one side of the sun, those don't matter. I have all of the data going back years and years and years. Alignments matter. Nothing else. Someone's like, well, what if we just happen to get high solar activity at that time? Oh, you mean at the peak of the 11-year sunspot cycle? Oh my goodness, that would be so shocking to have a high amount of solar activity at the peak of the sunspot cycle. Somebody said there was a paper out there that said the galactic current sheet was responsible for life on Earth. I can't find that comment anymore because I scrolled past it like a dumbass. But Matt, there you are. Did you send me that? I have not seen that one. And I don't miss much when it comes to the science papers on that topic. By the way, congratulations, everyone, on surviving the eclipse, the Devil's Comet, the 80-foot swell in the South Atlantic Ocean. That was so funny. What people don't realize, the Fukushima tsunami was 90 feet, but the swell from the earthquake was only 7 or 8 feet. When tsunamis go out, they're low like that. And then when they approach the coastline, they slow down and build up. So something that was an 80-foot swell, we're talking 300 to 400-foot tsunamis in Miami, Boston, New York. Of course it wasn't real. Spooked me for a minute. I'm not going to lie. I saw the anomaly and I was like, better check that one out. How do you reconcile God's promise never destroying the earth with water in the great disaster cycle? All right. Well, since you haven't heard this answer, which I have given again like 100 times, I will do it. But give me a second because I got a bunch of super chats here. Looking for evidence. In my humble opinion, the extreme difference between the near and far side of the moon is due to the electric discharge scarring between the Earth and the moon during the micronova's likelihood. It's very possible. I can't give you a definitive answer. DJ Dunham, thank you for the teal pair. Makes me happy. Thanks again from Tasmania. Love your work. Appreciate that very much. How do we reconcile? Oh, and there it is. All right. Yes, great job, everyone. We did it. Enough virgin sacrifices were offered to the sun god 36,000 years ago, Mono Lake, 24,000 years ago, Lake Mungo, Younger Dryas, now the Davidson event. That's fine. We can call it the Davidson event. Although in honor of the recently passed Doug Vogt, why don't we call it the Vogt event? All right, but now to the question, how do we reconcile God's promise to never destroy the earth with water again in the great disaster cycle? So for those of you who happen to know, my goodness, you guys got to just chill on the super chats for a second. The Guy New Zealand and Grateful Preps, thank you guys very much. Everybody else chill so I can answer this question real fast. Chill on the super chats. For those of you who know that you can't directly translate Hebrew into English, there's just some things you can't actually translate. Same goes for Aramaic to Hebrew, or Aramaic to Greek, or Hebrew to Greek, or any of those to Roman, the original Italian. There is so much we have just tried to do our best to translate. But one of the things we know in terms of linguistics is back then when they said the world, and by the way, they didn't say, God didn't say, I will never flood the earth again. They didn't have the word earth, okay? It wasn't a thing. So God didn't say, I will never flood the earth again. He promised to never flood their world. Now, back then, if you lived in Jerusalem, that was your world. But Egypt was another world. The desert was another world. The ocean was another world. They were worlds within the realm. And so it just so happens, as the axis of the tilt point, that part of the world will not be flooded this time. They get fire, the fire of the micronova, which happens to go along with the book. Other parts of the world get flooded, but not that part of the world. That part of the world will not get flooded. They will get the fire. That is how it is reconciled, by understanding not only the science of everything that has to happen to explain the evidence, but the linguistics, intricacies, and the minutiae of those details when it comes to ancient languages. I hope that answer was sufficient. By the way, extra hello to Grateful Preps, New Jersey. It's good to see you. He gonna baptize y'all. That's funny. Denver is going to slide into the Pacific. Just Denver. Oh, that'd be so nice. That would be so nice. I guess those of us here right now didn't ascend. Yep. We missed the rapture, guys. We missed it. We got left behind. And you said you think the Middle East will get hit with fire. Yeah, and Africa and parts of Europe. Wouldn't want to be there when the micronova goes off, unless I was underground. But then I still wouldn't want to be there. That's not where I'd want to come up. It's not where I want to spend my time between now and then. Whenever you get upset, lighten the mood with Cheryl Jackson Lee's ideas of the moon. Oh, my goodness. I'm not going to repeat them, but did anybody hear what that absolute Rhodes Scholar said about the moon?
It's mostly gaseous.
Good God. Uber Archangel, thank you for the compliment. I appreciate it. Oh, we got a genius on here saying the rapture won't be until April 21, 22-24. Oh, okay. Okay. My mistake. Bless your heart, buddy. What about flying to Mars with SpaceX? Oof. Not, I kind of like Elon, but no. No. What a terrible idea. Our cases fill us in. On what? Do you have a question? Good no. Good God. Oh, Roma doubling down, April 21 to 24 for the rapture. Again, bless your heart, my friend. Did I watch UFC 300? What in the history of knowing me makes you think I watched a UFC fight the other day? I did hear about what the guy said about libertarianism and stuff like that because I'm on Twitter, but no. No, I did not watch a UFC fight. Did you ever find any suitable old mines in the Canyon City region? It was a challenge, I recall. I found everything I needed to find in that part of the world, which is why it's where I'm bugging out. Not Canyon City, but... Hey, Ben, is the sudden switch polar vortex wind on the North Pole also related? No, and I did a video on that on March 30th. It was the March 30th morning show. This is my hyperthymesia kicking in. The reversal of the polar vortex happens, get ready, hold on to your butts, every single year. Now, it is true. This year's event was the seventh strongest since 1979. But it happens when the polar vortex breaks down in a sudden stratospheric warming event around that same time every year. Yes, this was a more extreme example. Not the most. It was seventh place since 1979. But it happens every year. Ben, you forgot to congratulate the survivors of the Great New Jersey Quake. Oh, yeah. Congratulations to you guys, too. Can we get pole flip insurance through Lloyd's? No, you can get it through me. If you guys want pole flip insurance, or better yet, Micronova. Here's what it is. I'm offering pole flip insurance with a Micronova rider, okay? All you need is 10 foot to stop all the radiation. Dude, all you need is about 1 foot to stop the radiation. The best part about radiation, I know that's a weird way to start a damn sentence. The best part about radiation is the more dangerous it is, the easier it is to block. Radio waves, not that dangerous. Super hard to block. Ultraviolet light, gamma rays, oh, the most dangerous. They ain't getting through our atmosphere. The only time gamma rays ever come to the ground is when they're terrestrial gamma flashes from lightning. Something from the sun that's a gamma energy isn't getting down here. X-rays aren't even getting down here. Those barely get past the ionosphere. At their strongest, they interact with the ozone. So, yeah, you really don't need much. I got kicked off Twitter for saying the truth. Kim, was that while Elon Musk was in charge? You should see the things I say on there. Are you planning any gardening at Observer Ranch? We are planning to survive the end of the world. What's the best commodities are best for? Where's the rest of your question? Okay. I'm trying to pick out some good questions here. I see somebody says they got Ben's monthly newsletter. Oh, do we have a special treat for you guys, especially those who are new members. So for those who don't know, every month, and this one will be coming out in like 2 or 3 days, we put out an e-magazine issue, and it's got all of the top science articles, all of the biggest updates from the last month, consolidated, explained, put into their proper place. If you don't have the greatest memory from watching all the videos I do every day, or if you don't have the opportunity to watch the videos every day and you're worried you might be missing something or forgetting something, people who have the monthly newsletter love it. But we're doing something a little extra special. We are going to, and I don't know if this is going to happen in like 2 or 3 days, or we're going to wait till the end of the month to do it. We've got to talk to Bailey about that. We are putting a link in there to every single issue we've done. Now, we started this in March of 2023, but basically either when this next issue comes out in 2 or 3 days or at the end of this month. So at some point between now and the end of April, we're going to be sending every e-magazine subscriber a link to get all of the issues that we have ever put out. We're talking, let me go actually look and see this here. Yeah, 14 issues, 168 science articles, 353 pages. Guys, that is more than my textbook. And that's going to everyone. For, if any of you guys don't have the monthly newsletter, it's probably the most worthwhile way that you can stay up to date on everything. It also happens to be the best way to support Suspicious Observers and Space Weather News. In that description box right below the video down there, that's where you get the e-magazine. We're not going to stop doing it every single month. And yeah, we got something special coming. And I know some of you are going to get it and you're going to read every single issue in one day, because that's how some of you roll. Like, geez. Anyway, now that I've missed like 400 comments in the chat, I'm going to... No one really understands real science at all in the general population. No kidding. My estimate for Judgment Day is the 24th of April. Why? Why? Somebody's asking about Scandinavia. After the pole flip, it'll be okay. The problem is, during the pole flip, the waves are going to be tremendously bad. And before that, we're probably going to have a CME that takes out global power, which means you've got 5-10 years, maybe a little more, of living in Scandinavia and Scandinavian winters with no electricity. If you think you can handle that in giant waves during the flip, go for it. Bet you have a what? Why is it extremely windy in Pennsylvania this year? Is it pole related? I don't know. Oh, you're just spamming that comment. Dude, someone's going to snipe you in a minute. Where to sign up? All right, well, they're a little behind. It's just right down there below the video. Goodness, look at all these people asking about Scandinavia. It's impossible for the Earth axis to flip, says Katja. With no due respect whatsoever, it's not impossible. And the Earth does. It has. And it will again very soon. With no due respect whatsoever. Hi, Ben. How do we know parts of Europe, Africa, and Asia are the ones getting burnt? I don't really understand that part. Wouldn't it depend on the time of day the sun pops? Goliath Slayer, I see that you have not kept up with everything, so let me explain this one. You know how the ancients could predict eclipses, but they thought that the moon and the sun were capricious gods that were listening to them and would get mad at them for what they did? Yeah, they could predict eclipses, but they didn't have a clue what the heck the mechanics were. That's where we are with what parts of the Earth are taking these hits, because we know where the burns are from the previous micronova, and they are ticking around the world in a very, very recognizable pattern. Same with the micronova shell impact ticking around the world in a very predictable pattern. Why it would be this predictable and why and how the sun and Earth managed to, all right, we're going to hit here. And we're going to hit here next time. And we're going to hit here next time. I don't understand, and nobody does. But that doesn't mean we can't predict where the next one is coming. Just like the ancients didn't actually know what the sun and the moon were, but they could predict eclipses. I hope that helps. I've gone over that in videos a couple of times. Time will tell. We'll talk later. As the plate shift, oh, that went too fast. Will the oil wells change or add to the type of gas they expel? put it this way. I'm sure there's going to be a whole bunch of crazy stuff that happens from a crustal perspective. But what you need to remember, this happens every 12,000 years. It has never killed the world before. It has never caused an anoxic event where people can't breathe. Yeah, okay, there are going to be some areas that are devastated. Nothing that's going to take out the entire world. And yes, I absolutely believe previous civilizations had nuclear power and other stuff like that. Probably stuff that was far more dangerous, and it still didn't kill the world. Anyway, scrolling. Remember me, the alien guy that told you the future. Dude, you and like 1,000 other people. In all honesty, isn't the planet that flips just the surface skin? Is it really that hard to understand? Okay, I mean, it is my opinion. It is just the crust that unlocks from the mantle. I am not completely ruling out a Jenna Bekov effect, tennis racket theorem, second axis theorem. You remember the guy who spun the T-handle in space and it kept flipping around over and over and over again? I'm not ruling it out. It's just that there are some physics problems with that when it comes to the Earth, and it is so much easier and actual workable math and mechanics to unlock the crust from the mantle and then tilt it over like that. That actually is something I can get my head around. But Draco, fair comment. Are satellites falling going to be a thing? Probably not. Most of them will burn up. And the ones that don't, honestly, are probably going to hit the ocean. Have you ever listened to Chuck Misler? No. Michael, you can ask where Noah's Ark is, seriously, all you want. I don't know. Nobody actually knows. And if one of my mods catches you just spamming the same stuff over and over again, they're going to snipe you, man. I don't want that to happen. This is a salt-free podcast today. How'd you like me pretending to care there? Was that good? Okay. Ben, where will the next micronova hit? I literally just described that at the... No salt. Could the sun have a pilot flip? Do you mean pole flip? The sun's poles flip every 11 years, and those are not related to this disaster cycle. The 11-year flip of the sun is what creates the sunspot cycle. Noah's Ark is in Turkey on Aryan Mountain. Maybe. Will caves protect from pole shifts if they don't collapse? Yeah. Do you believe we are alone on this planet? Not a chance in hell. Undercover Bird, thank you for the teal pair. I appreciate that. I feel myself desalinating as we speak. The volcanic smoke rings. You're talking about the ones from Etna? Yeah, that was kind of cool. It's also not the first time it's done it, though. Where the micronova hits, or how is the question? Okay, I'll just say this again. Based on the areas that have taken the hits before, the micronova flash and burning event will happen over that area of Egypt, Israel, Middle East, Northeast Africa, Southeast Europe, maybe even as far north as Moscow. That area is taking the flash. The West Pacific will get the shell impact and likely the great arc discharge downward, the thunderbolt of the gods. I'm not saying again. YouTube is keeping you out of my feed again. I saw the live feed and it disappeared right in front of me. Yeah, I don't trust YouTube. If you guys ever wake up one morning and it's usually the time when I will have posted already and you don't see the post, just presume YouTube didn't tell you about it. Never presume I just didn't show up that day. Have you seen the 90-degree turn on the Hawaii volcanic tail? That guy in New Zealand, did you miss me talking about that at the start of the show? I could swear you're the guy who asked me about that at the start of the show. I discussed that at the start of the show. If you missed it, man, go back and watch the start of the show. It was one of the first things we discussed. Pete Benson, what's up? Much love to you. Can't wait to see you at the ranch, my friend. Boudica. Thank you for the teal pair. Am I saying that right? Boudica? Boudica? I don't know. I like your name, though. It's cool. And I like the teal pair. Somebody said, I asked an honest question, unrelated and salt-free. Yeah. Well, too bad for you. You didn't ask it again right there because I only can see maybe 1 or 2% of the comments that come through. I happen to see yours right there, but you didn't ask your question there. You just complained like a girl, like a little wee girl.
I asked a question. He didn't answer it.
All right. No, no, no. No salt. No salt. No salt. Tiny Tacos. Yes, I have a video that covers the burn spots. When I was describing it earlier, I said I had done a video on that. It was from a while ago, and I'm not going to go find it here right now in the middle of a live stream. You think they will cap the pyramids to try and grounding rod the lightning? No, I don't think they'll do that. Be interesting to watch if they did, though. That'd be cool. Are we jumping off the Boson-Higgs conveyor belt right now? I'm not sure I understand your question. I like it, though. Did you guys hear that Higgs died? The guy who came up with the whole Higgs boson thing? Yeah, he died. Based on your experience, Chuck Missler, you understand. I don't know how to understand that comment, though. Hi, Ben. What will happen to the Canary Islands? Nothing good. By the way, thanks for everybody explaining me how you pronounce Boudica. Okay. Thanks for taking the time to answer earlier. Right on, Goliath. Appreciate you. Somebody said, how's my dog? Somehow, Hope is still alive. For those of you who know, we lost Achilles 2 Thanksgivings ago. That was hard. That was hard. When Hope goes, that'll be even harder because my kids have formed bonds with Hope now. All right, blasted cat outdoors. How do they determine the impact? They? How did I determine it? Well, I fully explained it in that video, including showing the papers that very clearly showed where the most mass extinctions were, continent by continent, throughout history. So this was me knowing where the major burn scars are in the rock all over the world, me knowing approximately how old they are, and then happening to line that up with where the major megafaunal extinctions were at these cycle points throughout time in history. That's Channel Invigliotti in Reviews of Geophysics, a paper I've shown probably 1,000 times on this channel. They. Laura Garwood, thank you for the teal pair. That makes me happy. But Laura, you knew that already. Facilitator of Fun, thank you for the teal pair. Should get a parrot. They live forever, if only. What alternative energy source other than solar would you personally try to cultivate in preparation for the coming disaster? Steam power, maybe for mechanical things, not electrical. If you're talking about electrical, no. Just no. Just no. Because here's the thing. We're probably going to lose global power a decade before the micronova. Let's say you magically happen to save something technological. The micronova is going to take it out. Let's say you somehow impossibly. Managed to avoid the first solar kill shot and the micronova. What happens in the wake of the micronova? The reorganization of the surface of the sun and super flares daily for weeks, months, maybe years. You have to live without electricity in this thing eventually. Might as well just go with that. Oh, we got everybody talking about their pets that have died now. Jeez, what did I do? What have I done? I teach people how to milk cows and goats by hand for this event. Oh, Zen, that is cool. Can you see magnetism? No. Does it bother you that your knowledge is being ignored or suppressed by the powers that be? Not one bit. Those who are supposed to know will find their way. Susie Rose Finley, our resident Viking, thank you for the teal pair. Appreciate it. Spider Ron says, muscle power, better get hard. That's what she said. Let's see. My Chihuahua will live forever. I hope so, Nancy. That'd be cool. What do you think about polygonal masonry? I have no idea. I literally have no opinion on that. How many days are you into your period? Well, don't worry. I'm just spotting at this point. Light Seeker. Appreciate you very much. I don't know how to deal with some of this stuff. Should I paint my roof blue? Couldn't hurt. Couldn't hurt. Is there a chance bullets would explode during? Yeah, it's possible. Do I think it's likely? I don't know if I would say likely, but if we're having the conversation about metal being at risk, then yeah, you got to think about bullets. You got to think about canned food. You got to think about all kinds of stuff. You can mitigate a lot of that by just putting it in a plastic container. And I know they sell plastic ammo containers. According to the Bible, 4,300 years ago. All right, Zippy, since you seem to think it's okay to comment when you just opened the video and started it at the beginning, and we're 47 minutes in. So in 47 minutes, you're going to see this. One, don't do that. Recognize that the rest of us are 47 minutes ahead of you. And also, no. The Bible, not everything in the Bible should be taken literally. I believe there's a lot more actual factual history in the Bible than it's given credit for by many. But it is also unquestionably a mix of facts, metaphor, and allegory. And if you don't know which is which, and if you don't understand the language intricacies and minutiae like I described earlier, you end up like Zippy here. Alcohol production as an alternative fuel source. I don't see why not. You don't need electricity to make alcohol. And whether you're drinking it or you're using it for something else, couldn't hurt. It will also be very valuable in terms of trade. TNC, no salt. So go solar and be prepared is what you're saying. No, do not go solar. Solar panels are... I'm specifically saying do not rely on solar power. That is not going to work. Okay? That will absolutely not work. Elizabeth, thank you for the teal pair. Patrick, thank you for the teal pair. Oh, I'm feeling so much better right now. I can't tell what you guys are laughing at. Is it what I said to Zippy or when I said I was just spotting at this point? I figured girls are going to get that one. There's little evidence of old civilizations other than rocks. Does any metal have a chance? No. Could our iron ore be remnants of old items? Mark, that your last sentence, yeah, that's very possible. But I mean, when people say if humans just disappeared right now in 2,000 years, you could come here and barely know we were here. It's because all the metal stuff we've made is going to oxidize and rust. It'll be gone. Not to mention the fact that something as powerful as the micronova is going to melt half of it anyway. So no, we wouldn't have too much metal left over. Subarctica, asking about my new book, Earth Disaster Cycle, Table of Contents. Does it differ from the next Under the World? Those books are very different. Very, very different. The Earth Disaster Cycle, the newest one, is meant to be a layman's introduction. It's got a lot of pictures, a lot of simplified explanations. Yeah, I would say those are very different books. Do you think they have colonies on other planets and are not telling us? I highly doubt it. And it's not necessarily because they don't have the technology. They might. Humans probably don't do so well outside of Earth's magnetic field. Remember that hypomagnetic situation we were talking about? You get us out of this magnetic field and then you bombard us with cosmic rays, our body's just not going to do very well. I wouldn't go so far as to say we're trapped here forever. But we might be. Tyler, thank you for the waving lemon. That's cute. Sun to Earth ratio size difference. Sun flips every 11 years. Earth flips every 6,000 years. Meaning, could that help predict the exact date of Earth flip? I don't know. I don't think so. I really don't think so. Besides, the sun doesn't flip every exactly 11 years. The sunspot cycle ranges from 9 to 13 years. So definitely no. Could something happen during a flip, like magnetic field not coming back? No. The same thing that unlocks the crust from the mantle, the induction from something as powerful as a micronova, goes all the way to the core and juices us back up. If we get the zenith of the disaster, we get the golden age right afterwards. This is not the end. It's the next stage of Earth. And yeah, we got to run the gauntlet to get there. But once you do, it's kind of like, okay, it's like in Hunger Games, or like Hunger Games was supposed to be. Oh, you're a victor? Lavish life. Now, granted, if you saw Catching Fire, you know, it didn't work out so well for Katniss. The point is that that's how it was supposed to be. Once you were a victor, once you got through the Hunger Games, you were set for life. I think that's a better way of thinking about it, if I may dumb it down to that level. Thank you. Is there a sign-up waiting list for post-catastrophe refugees at the Observer Ranch? I'm telling you this. If you are not one of the long-term members at Observer Ranch, do not try to show up. Do not try to show up. It's a bad idea. There's virtually no chance you will make it there, first of all. And second of all, if you do make it there, we're going to see you as an invader. Considering NASA isn't really on board with the magnetic universe, do you doubt the available information from them sometimes? No. Not the ones that I get my head around. So here's the thing. I know who at NASA has bought my books. I know who at NASA knows this stuff and just doesn't think that they can come publicly with it. I know which departments and which missions at NASA have their heads screwed on straight. And you might not know this because I do report a lot of their stuff. I don't report about 85 to 90% of the science NASA releases because I read it and I either can't verify it or I straight up don't believe it in any way, shape, or form. doesn't make sense. It doesn't pass my review. The stuff I share with you passes my review. And not only does it usually do that, it usually comes from one of my friends there. So, yeah, I hope that's an okay answer to your question. By the way, I'm also going to say that's got to be the weirdest super chat amount I've ever seen, $6.28. But I like it for some reason. The number looks good to my eyes. Billy, thank you for the teal pair. Appreciate that very much. John says, sorry for always using bad grammar. Bad grammar equals cheaper question. Thanks for all you do. Much love. Sorry, I lack funds. No, John, it's cool. I appreciate you. Diego Lou. Hi, Ben. Sorry I've missed a few of your live streams, and thank you for what you do. It's okay, man. You're here now, and there's a very good chance that this one's going to get unlisted the moment we're done, just like I do with most of them. I don't like keeping the live streams up. If you catch it, great. Love to have you. But I'm usually just yelling at trolls and other stuff like that. Although, I kind of like to think I haven't been too salty today. I've been trying not to be salty. Yeah, I jacked up Zippy. Fine. Other than that, I have not been too salty today. Rock Doc, thank you for the teal pair. Makes me happy. It to make him happy. What are the chances of you turning into the governor from The Walking Dead at your ranch? I have no idea what. I know that The Walking Dead is a show about zombies, but I've never actually watched the show. So I don't have any frame of reference for being able to answer that. I do know this. Anything that I see as even potentially threatening, and my rubric for that is going to be way down, I will see as potentially threatening to my three children. So the salt will flow, proverbially speaking. Just trying to beat the other guy's $6.28. Lone Wolf. Lone Wolf, can I give you a heart for that? There we go. I'm giving you a heart, Lone Wolf. That was awesome. Not super easy to make me chuckle. Numbers are special and with purpose. So I hear, says Sledgehammer Wedge with a 314. On a more serious note, thank you for keeping us informed. Right on, Lone Wolf. Oh my goodness. All right. Somebody playing off me not being too salty today wrote Sugary Ben? ? I don't think I like that. I don't think I like Sugary Ben, RK. I don't think I'm going to adopt that one. Yeah, I could have wore the Pure Blood shirt, but I felt like wearing this one today. Anyway, what did I miss? Okay, do you know remote view? I don't know any remote viewers, and I don't believe half the ones I hear about. He says they remote viewed the younger Dryas and says it was sun-caused, and he sends people to your website. Very cool. Appreciate that, but no, I don't know him, and I know a lot of people who they heard about remote viewing, and then they just claim to be able to do it. There are a lot of frauds in that field. I'm not saying all of them. But I don't have any way to verify who's who. And I've never heard anyone predict something for the future and then that exact thing happened when they said it was going to happen the way they said it was going to happen. So I believe, but am generally skeptical at first. Tesla energy's flowing here. Ooh, I like that comment. With a 939. Yeah. All right. Well, guys, this has been fun. As most of you know, I really only do this for like an hour. But of course, at the end of the hour, we get tons of super chats like this. So here we go. Tip for the newsletter hot link. That will be awesome. Thank you for the low sodium eyes only podcast. Yeah, I can't even begin to explain. When Bailey told me, and for those who don't know, Bailey's been with us for like a decade, helping out Kat and I. When she told me that we have 13 issues, well, I mean, I knew that, but 168 of the best articles from the last year, 353 pages, longer than my longest book. Holy cow. I had no idea we had amassed so much. I mean, I just kind of go about my business. I do the daily shows. I do the afternoon shows. I read the papers. We do the monthly newsletter. I had no idea we had amassed a textbook. And it is at no additional price. It's literally like you get the monthly e-magazine. We're just tossing you all of this stuff. And I think it's a great idea. I couldn't love it anymore. Fantastic. You could always go with Pickled Ben. Maybe. I like pickles. Joking aside, what do you, thank you for all you do. Denver sucks with teeth. Oh God, burning rage. You had to give me that in my head. Barbarian, nice to see you. 1111, teal pear. One more slice of pop for you. Ah, gotta love that. Clever. The no shirt is rather appropriate. You are building an arc of knowledge, so those that understand have a chance to survive. I bet Noah got saltier. Yeah, something tells me he was probably salty by the end of the whole thing. Many blessings. May the Lord Jesus protect us all. I will mirror that back out to everybody. Absolutely, absolutely. Or however that's supposed to be said. Danny, thank you for the support. Same to you, Ken. In your most honest answer, these billionaires building those great and very expensive bunkers, are they going to survive? Probably not. Definitely not Zuckerberg if he's going to Hawaii. What a terrible idea. Bezos has a good shot. Bezos has a good shot. I don't know where Elon Musk's is. But, you know, he's got the Boring Company. He's making tunnels all over the place. Yeah. The best one I've heard about is Jeff Bezos. And I hate saying that. I have virtually nothing good to say about Jeff Bezos. I'll tell you this. The dude's bug out plan is pretty damn good. Pretty damn good. I have a video on it. It's called Disaster Plan of the World's Richest Man. And I know Elon is now richer than him. But back when I made the video, Bezos was the richest man in the world. So anyway. Remotely viewing my way through South Fork, dropping off bunny kits to the Amish. Oh, it's you. Trading up eggs for them and being at the lunch Tuesday. Oh, missed. Is there any chance you could, like, also, by the way, I'm looking forward to seeing you. Can you, like, come back around when the ranch opens with a bunny kit for us? Like, we don't have the ability to do that yet. We are still in the construction phase. Almost done. We've literally got the most annoying little red tape left. But yeah. Missed. I'll see you Tuesday. We'll chat. Susie says, down 15 pounds. Thank you, Ben, pointing me in the direction of the carnivore diet. Live like a Viking. Great to hear that, Susie. All right. Any thoughts on keeping the secret from liberals? Okay, yeah. People voting for Biden, Democrats, liberals, people with pink, blue, green hair. Everything that I've talked about and all the videos I make on my channel are complete nonsense. You can just ignore them. You don't need to worry about it. You don't need to prep. The sun is your friend. The earth can't turn over and everything is going to be fine forever and ever. If you are not in that group I just described, my God, listen to every word I say. Let's go, Brandon. Wish I knew how to get my lady on board. Might just have to call it a day in 2046. Can't leave her. I feel you on that. All right, guys. We're going to call it a day right there. Best of luck, RG4697. But anyway, let's go, Brandon. Denver sucks. If there's Democrats watching, I kid. Everything will be fine forever and ever. Yeah, I'll see you guys in the morning for the daily show. Be safe, everyone.